Silence! 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 It is the order. The most worshipful Grand Master, the most worshipful Grand Lodge, Prince Hall Grand Lodge, the jurisdiction of Pennsylvania, Dr. Murphy J. Keller III, that the Cornerstone last ceremony to be performed at the Saunders House, 100 East Lancaster Avenue, Wynnewood, PA. The craft has been notified and team duly assembled to commence the same. We thank you for your attention and your assistance. Most worshipful, sir. Right worshipful, Grand Secretary. Most worshipful, Grand Master. You will read the request to lay this cornerstone.
Saunders House, Mainline Senior Care Alliance, July 18th, 2013, to the most worshipful Grand Master Dr. Murphy J. Keller III, number 20, 4301 North Broad Street, Philadelphia, PA. Dear Dr. Keller, at the suggestion of Mr. Brian Austin, Director of Dining Services at the Saunders House in Wynnewood, I'm writing to request the services of the Prince Hall Grand Lodge to assist in the rededication of the Saunders House building and placing of a new cornerstone. Saunders House is a residential health care center for older adults providing long-term residential living and short-term rehabilitation. Founded in 1864 under the name of the Old Men's Home of Philadelphia, Saunders House is now located at the foothill Lankenau Hospital, just off of City Avenue in Wynnewood, PA. Our address is 100 East Lancaster Avenue, Wynnewood, PA, 19096. Although the home originally operated out of the 39th and Powelton in West Philadelphia from April the 20th, 1864, 1973. More recently location of the home has been on Lancaster Avenue in Wynnewood since 1973. As our current building does not have a cornerstone, we are arranging to have one made in honor of our 150th year of continuous operation. We would like to rededicate the Wynnewood building by installing a cornerstone on Saturday, April the 5th, 2014. Your services to help conduct this rededication and placing of a new cornerstone will be greatly appreciated. In addition, if there's any other way you would care to participate in the upcoming year celebration of the 150th anniversary, we would be happy to have you join us. I understand that St. Thomas Church, located nearby, was founded by the first Grand Master, Prince Hall Masons, almost 200 years ago. Thank you for your consideration of this request, and I will await your reply sincerely, Susan Aragon.
Right Worshipful Deputy Grandmaster, you will be the dispensation to lay this cornerstone.
That you will be,
Grandmaster. Most worshipful Prince Hall Grand Lodge, free and accepted Masons of Pennsylvania,
from the office of the deputy at large, dispensation to all whom these presents shall come. Application having been made to permit Worshipful Grand Lecturer Wayne W.R. Howard, number 23, to assemble a team of Worshipful District Lecturers, and under his direction, to perform a cornerstone ceremony at the Saunders House, 100 East Lancaster Avenue, Wynnewood, PA, on Saturday, April the 5th, 2014, at 1 o'clock p.m. Now know ye that I, Edward M. Brooks, past master number 87, Worshipful Deputy at Large, in and for the jurisdiction of Pennsylvania, by virtue of the power and authority in me vested by the most worshipful Grandmaster, Murphy J. Keller, number 3, Murphy J. Keller III, number 20, do hereby authorize and empower said lecturer to act as prescribed above, in accordance with the ancient usage and custom of Freemasonry, and not to otherwise, and for so doing, these presents shall be their sufficient warrant, given under my hand and seal this 5th day of April, 2014, A.D., 6014 A.L. Edward M. Brooks, Worshipful Deputy at Large, jurisdiction of Pennsylvania.
Right Worshipful Senior Grandmaster.
Most Worshipful Grandmaster.
It has ever been the custom of most strapped, free, and accepted masons to lay the cornerstone
church,
public buildings, and monuments when requested to do so by those in authority. We have here for their convenience to be craft here for that very purpose. And it is now our will and pleasure that they give us their attention and assistance in this work. This is our will and pleasure. You will communicate to the junior Grand Warden and he to the brethren that they, having due notice, this cornerstone may be laid in ample form.
Yours is function of aid, Worshipful Grand Master. Right Worshipful Junior Grand Warden.
Right Worshipful Senior Grand Warden.
It is the will and pleasure of the Most Worshipful Grand Master of Masons that the brethren here assembled do now assist him in laying this cornerstone. This you will communicate to the brethren that they have in due notice may govern themselves accordingly.
Most Worshipful Grand Master's order should be punctually obeyed.
Of the Most Worshipful Grand Master, as communicated to me by the White Worshipful Senior Grand Warden. Of this, you will take due notice and govern accordingly.
Grand Chapel.
Most Worshipful Grand Master.
The fitting prayer for them.
Order shall be promptly obeyed, as Worshipful Grand Master.
Let us pray. Supreme Grand Master of the universe, bounteous source of every good to the children of men, thou who didst inspire thine ancient servant Solomon to build unto thee a house, and didst of thine own infinite grace accept the workmanship of his hand, and didst condescend thy spirit to dwell therein, grant to us that grace today that we may make an auspicious commencement of our labors and lay this cornerstone upon the eternal principles of justice, piety, reliance upon God, and sacred truth. Bless our Mother Earth to bear firmly upon its bosom the edifice which today we dedicate. Bless the hands of the bearers of burdens who have and may hereafter bring hither materials for the walls to continually stand. Bless the wisdom that contrived, the strength that executed, and the wisdom that supported the beauty that doth adorn this building, that in the eyes of all beholders, it may present a monument of prosperity of those who follow on to know the Lord. May the words of peace ever resound in its chambers. May the praise of God be its harmony. May its dwellers dwell together in unity and enjoy the delights of pleasantness and peace. Keep this edifice from the hands of evil designing men. preserve it equally from the lightning of heavens, from hurricanes, from earthquakes, from conflagration, from the sword of the invader, from all manner of evil. May the foliage of many a returning spring open in greenness and beauty about it. May the storms of winter be softened from its wonted rigor and harm it not. Great God, who hath upheld our nation through generations past, preserve us from the calamities of war, from civil strife, and from all manner of evil and influences of sin. Amen. Amen.
Right worshipful Grand Treasurer.
Most worshipful Grand Master.
My brother, on occasions such as the present, it has ever been the part of the craft to place in the cavity of the stone placed at the northeast corner of the building certain memorials appearing in which it was erected, so that if in the lapse of ages, the fury of the elements, the violence of man, or the slow but certain ravages of time should somehow lay bare its foundation, an enduring evidence may be found by succeeding to bear testimony to the untiring energy of Prince Hall.
My brother has sent to the prophet to prepare. It has been, most of the Grandmaster. Memorial, and now before me.
Right worshipful Grand Secretary.
Most worshipful Grand Master.
You will read the list of memorials so that all may be informed.
A coin of the present time. A journal of the present date. Current copy of the Light magazine. Copy of the latest proceedings of the Most Worshipful Prince Hall Grand Lodge. Copy of the town records.
Right worshipful Grand Treasurer.
Most worshipful Grand Master.
He will deposit the particles in the canister prepared, and may the Grand Architect of the universe, in his infinite wisdom, grant that ages upon ages shall pass away, ere it again be seen by human eyes. Amen?
So it be.
Jesus.
Worshipful Grand Master.
Grand Marshal.
I present to you our Grand Architect, who will give you the tools of the craft.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, the necessary preparations have been made for laying the cornerstone of this building. I present you with the plumb. Square. Level. And square. Those useful implements of the craft by which you will be able to ascertain the materials are properly prepared and the cornerstone about to be laid is well formed, true, and trusted.
Most worshipful Grand Master, I find the cornerstone to be square. Craftsmen have performed it.
Right Worshipful Senior Grand Master.
Most Worshipful Grand Master.
What is the jewel of your heart?
The level, Most Worshipful Grand Master.
And what are its moral and Masonic uses?
Morally, it is an emblem of equality, and its use is to prove horizontals.
Right Worshipful Brother, apply it to the portion of the stone that needs to be approved, and make your report.
Your orders shall be punctually obeyed, Most Worshipful Grand Master. Master, I find the cornerstone level. The craftsmen have performed their duty.
Right Worshipful, Junior Grand Warden.
Most Worshipful Grand Master.
My brother, what is the jewel of yours?
The plum, Most Worshipful Grand Master.
And what of its moral and Masonic uses?
Morally, it's an emblem of rectitude of life, and its use is the true perfect victory.
Right Worshipful Brother, apply it to the portion of the stone that needs to be approved. Make due report. By the ancient implements of Freemasonry. And I testify that the craftsmen have skillfully and faithfully performed their duties. And I declare that this cornerstone is well formed, true, trusted, and accurately laid according to the principles of our art.
And may the work thus auspiciously begun be continued and completed by the benign principles of peace, harmony, and brotherly love. Let the elements of consecration now be presented to you.
This corn, I distribute, as a symbol of goodness and plenty. May the blessings of a bounteous heaven be showered upon us and upon all like patriotic and benevolent undertakings, and inspire the hearts of the people with virtue, wisdom, and gratitude. Amen?
So it is.
Is a symbol of joy and gladness. May the great ruler of the universe bless and prosper our national, state, and city government, preserve the union of the states, and may Freemasonry be a bond of friendship and brotherly love which shall endure through all time.
Within us continuously. May the Grand Master of the heaven and the earth shelter and protect the widows and orphans, shield and defend them from all their trials and vicissitudes, and to bestow mercy upon the bereaved, the afflicted, and their sorrow, that they may know sorrow and trouble no more. Amen.
So it is.
Public grand honors, Grand Marshal.
Public grand honors, my brother.
Grandmaster of Masons in the laying of this cornerstone. I now present the implements of your profession into your hands. Entrusting you
with the superintendence and direction of the work, having full faith in your skill and capacity to conduct the same in such a manner that the building may be sustained in order, harmony, and beauty, and being perfected in strength, that it may answer every purpose for which it is intended, to your credit, and to the satisfaction and honor of those entrusted with you. Brethren, here assembled. Be it known to you that we be lawful masons, true and faithful to the laws of our country, and engaged by our solemn obligation to fear God, that great architect of the universe. Now, we have among us, concealed from the eyes of all men, secrets which cannot be divulged, nor have never been found out. But these secrets are lawful and honorable, and not repugnant to the laws of God nor man. They were entrusted in honor and peace to the masons of ancient times, and being transmitted to us, it is our duty to convey them unimpaired to the latest posterity. Now, unless our craft were good, our calling out, we would not have lasted for many, many centuries, nor would we have been honored with the patronage of so many illustrious men down through all ages. We are gathered here today, in the presence of all, to build a house. A house which we pray God may deserve to prosper, by being the place of concourse for good men, and by promoting peace, harmony, and brotherly love throughout the world until time shall be no more.
Amen?
So holy day.
Brother Orator.
Most worshipful Grandmaster.
My brother, enlighten us with further understanding of our purpose here today.
Your orders shall punctually obey, most worshipful Grandmaster.
Symbolism of the cornerstone is full of significance. The property laid inside of the grates is full of significance, which refers to its form, to its situation, to its permanence, and its concentration. As to its form, it must be perfectly level on all surfaces, and in its solid contents, a cube. Now, the square is the symbol of morality, and the cube of truth. In its situation, it lies between the north, the place of darkness, and the east, the place of light. And hence, this symbolizes the Masonic progress from darkness to light, and from ignorance to knowledge. the permanence and durability of the cornerstone, which will last long after the building in whose foundation it was placed has fallen into decay, is intended to remind all of us assembled that when this earthly house of our tabernacle shall have passed away, we have within us a sure foundation of eternal life, a cornerstone of immortality, an emanation that pervades all the spiritual contexts and must survive the tomb and rise triumphant and eternal over the decaying dust of death and the grave. The cornerstone, when deposited in its appropriate place, is carefully inspected with the necessary implements of the operative mason. The square, the lug, and the plumb, themselves all symbolic in meaning, and is then declared to be well-formed, true, and trusted. Thus, the master mason is taught that his virtues are to be tested by temptation and trial, by suffering and adversity, before it can be called by the master builder of souls to be materials worthy for the spiritual building of eternal life, fitted as living stones for that house not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. And lastly, in the ceremony of depositing the cornerstone, the elements of Masonic consecration are produced, and the stone is solemnly set apart by the pouring of corn, wine, and oil upon its surface, emblematic of the nourishment, refreshment, and joy, an ancient reward for the faithful performance of duty. But what is a cornerstone? A cornerstone is known to be the foundation of an edifice, as the foundation upon which the entire structure is supposed to rest. It is considered by operative masons as the most important stone in the edifice. The beautiful allegory of the cornerstone is further illustrated by by the term of the great biblical apostle Paul in his letter to the church of Ephesus, speaking about the household of God to the early followers of the Christian church. He says in Ephesians 2nd chapter, verses 20 and 21, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom the building fitly laid all about, and holy temple in the Lord. May the grand architect of the universe look down with beneficence upon our present undertaking and crown this splendid edifice with every success. Amen.
So will it be.
Grand Chaplain,
most worshipful Grand Master.
A closing prayer.
The order shall be promptly obeyed, most worshipful Grand Master. Let us pray. Glory be to God on high, on earth peace and goodwill toward men. O Lord, we most heartily beseech thee with thy favor to behold and bless this assemblage. Pour down like the dew that falls upon the mountains thy mercy upon thy servants engaged in the solemn ceremonies of this day. Bless all the workmen who have and shall hereafter erect, and maintain this edifice. Grant them in love and life, health and prosperity. Preserve them to live in your faith. And by thy mercy, thy will, and thy forgiveness, to attain everlasting life in thy mansion, in thy holy temple, not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Amen.
So would it be.
Grandma!
Conservator of Prince Hall Masons in Pennsylvania. He is a past master in his own right, hailing from Jericho Lodge number 20. All Prince Hall Masons, please rise as I bring to you the most worshipful Grand Master of Prince Hall Masons in and for the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, the Honorable Dr. Murphy J. Keller III. Hear ye him.
Thank you so very kindly, sir. Brethren, please be seated and thank you for being obedient to Masonic protocol. God of our ages past, God of our years to come, God of our shelter during the stormy blast, God of our eternal home. We are gathered here today to rededicate the Saunders House. We want to first of all thank you for the cordial invitation. I say to the executive director, the staff, members and individuals who have participated thus far on the program, words cannot describe how you make this organization feel when you think enough of us that we can perform ceremonies of this magnitude. We don't get the opportunity very often to perform a ceremony as you have witnessed here today. But I'm so thankful that we have a number of talented individuals in this organization. And I thank you for giving us enough time to prepare to dedicate this building and rededicate it in the form that I trust and believe that it truly deserves. I understand that one of your own staff members, Mr. Brian Austin, may have twisted some arms to make sure that you were aware of who we are. Brian happens to be the assistant director of the convention department for our organization. He's also a, let me say, skilled in the culinary arts area. We look forward to taking part of something that I trust and I'm aware that he has prepared for us on this day. The old man's home that existed for 109 years. And just recently, you had one of your residents who happened to have been one of ours. His name was Brother Raymond Bowman, a member of Corinthian Lodge number 114 in the Philadelphia area that we refer to as the First Masonic District. He was looking forward to this day. He looked forward to meeting his Grand Master. And as I believe God would have it, he had an opportunity to do so on the third Sunday in December, when we celebrated one of our most cherished festive days, St. John the Evangelist Day. I had an opportunity to exchange hands, to take a picture with him, to talk to him, to allow him to give to me what I oftentimes need, to motivate me to continue to do those things that we feel that God would have us to do. There are members of his family who are here today. We trust that you are blessed during this time. And I say that because Brother Bowman recently was called from labor to reward. And I understand that his last rites are going to be given on this coming Wednesday. Certainly his lodge is prepared to perform the duties upon a request of the same from the family, what we refer to as a burial service. God blessed him to be with us for 105 years. Not very many individuals will have the opportunity to say that they were here with us on this earth for that period of time. And as we stand here today as Grand Master, I want you to know that as an organization, we have a number of goals, inclusive of but not limited to our present theme: erecting towers of power, our youth through building blocks of faith. We believe that the future of organizations such as ours rests in the hands of our young people. And it's what we do for them today that we trust they will remember on tomorrow. We use as a biblical scripture to support our efforts, taken from Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is the substance of those things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And as one of the five goals that we have, community involvement, this is one that epitomizes that goal, that we were able to be present here today and rededicate the Saunders House. Would you please join me and giving accolades to that very fine team that performed the service. That team was under the direct supervision of the Worshipful Grand Lecturer, the Most Worshipful Prince All Grand Lodge of Pennsylvania, Wayne W. R. Howard of John S. Watson Lodge, number 23. I would ask, as the executive director comes forward when I take my seat to bring acknowledgments, that each of you would remain seated and or standing in your present position, as we who have assembled here today as Prince Hall Masons will depart from our current location in a reception. God bless you. God keep you. Forever remains my prayer. God loves you, and so do I. And I humbly remain Dr. Murphy J. Keller III of Jericho Lodge number 20, Most Worshipful Grand Master of Prince All Masons for the jurisdiction of Pennsylvania. Thank you for the opportunity, and I bid you all a most pleasant good afternoon.
Where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world, we're walking the light. You lead for light from where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world, we're walking the light. You lead for light from where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world, we're walking the light. You speak for light from where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world, we're walking the light. You speak for light from where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night. Jesus, the light of the world, we're walking the light. You lead for light from where the dewdrops of mercy shine bright. Shine